Hi, Movie Brief is here, and today I am going to explain an adult, erotic film which is called Village of Doom. Ahead spoiler. Watch out and take care. At the beginning of the movie we see Tsujio, who lives with his grandmother in a small town. Many people of this town were in the military. That's why Tsujio also wanted to join the military. But her grandmother doesn't want that. Tsujio was good at studies, so his grandmother wanted him to become a teacher. Well, nowadays Tsujio's health seems to be deteriorating. So he goes to the doctor, but the doctor does not know much about his illness. Just tells him to eat good food. The next day when Tsujio is sitting in the mountains, so he looks at Yasuo, who was his cousin. Both of them liked each other. Both of them also wanted to marry each other. But due to the family relationship between them, all this was not possible. One night when Tsujio coughs profusely, he can't even sleep, so he goes out for a walk. Then he hears some sound from the nearby house. He sees that the head of the town is in love with a woman. This woman's husband was in the military, in his absence she was doing this dirty work. Tsujio ignores all this and moves on. So he sees some people with sticks and sticks. He asks them why is he roaming like this at night. So he told that a boy named Tadaki, along with his friends, seduces women and falls in love with them. Whose husband is going to the military to protect the country. These people were unaware of the truth of their chief Yuzo. Tadaki also loved Yuzo with the ladies of the town. Tadaki used to just come to the town to steal the eggs of chickens. The next night again Tsujio can't sleep. Seeing Yuzo with that lady last night. Now he too goes towards her house to make love with that woman. But he could not understand whether that woman would also love him or not. Thinking this, he approaches her. And he falls in love with her. She also supports him because she is such a woman. A few days later, a woman named Mayoko arrives at Tsujio's house. This is the same woman who often borrowed money from her grandmother. Today grandmother is not at home. So Mayoko starts looking at Tsujio. She is tempted to get it. She says that her husband has gone out of the house for a few days. If he wants, he can come to his house. On hearing this, Tsujio goes to Mayoko's house on the pretext of giving money. Where they both fall in love. After this, Tsujio often has fun with Mayoko. It goes on like this for a few days, after which the medical process of the army starts. In which Tsujio also goes where the doctor tells him that he has TV. Because of which he cannot join the army. Because at that time TV there was no cure for the disease. The Tsujio breaks down when this disease is detected. If everyone comes to know in the same town too, then everyone keeps distance from him. Yasu also leaves his cousin. Because she was going to marry many more at the behest of the family members. One day Tsujio's health gets worse. So a woman named Kazuko gives him a cloth. Tsujio is very happy to see him. There is still someone who is not running away from him. Tsujio is heartily influenced by Kazuko. But one day he sees Kazuko having fun with his friend. So he gets very angry. Seeing her, Kazuko runs away. Tsujio tells his friend that he doesn't want to take Kazuko away from him because she helps him. Maybe she loves me too. Then Tsujio's friend tells her that she doesn't love him. She had helped him because he did not know about his illness. Tsujio doesn't believe what he says, so he goes to Kazuko's house. He does not know her identity because of the darkness. So he starts talking to his mother instead of Kazuko. When Kazuko's mother comes to know, she runs away saying that she will first do some business and then talk. Tsujio is now on his way home from here when he sees Yuzo and his men beating Tadakiki and hanging him from a tree on the way. The next day the police arrive. Tsujio is also interrogated, but he doesn't know how to tell. But Yuzo gets to know from his words. Tsujio has seen him doing this scandal. Tsujio, to survive from him and his men, goes to the city and buys rifles. But when he comes home he hears his grandmother talking to a woman. She is saying that she has found a relationship for Kazuko. He also got Yasuko married. But now they are going to get divorced. Because her husband has come to know about her and Yasuko's affair. Upon learning of all this, Sugio goes to the woman's house and starts fighting with her. He snatched Kazuko from him along with Yasuko. Sugio was upset so goes to Mayoko's house. But there her husband is found. Who washes it? After which the people of the town considered Sugio to be a threat and get his rifle caught. After all this, Sugio gets even more upset. And his health starts getting worse. He realizes that he doesn't have much time now. But he didn't want to die. The next day he brings a rifle from the city to take revenge on the people of the town. And when night falls, he first kills his grandmother. So that after what he is going to do today, his grandmother should not have to live in shame. Now Tsujio goes to his neighbor's house and kills him. After this, he goes to Kazuko's house and kills his entire family. Because Kazuko didn't appreciate her love. After this Tsujio kills all those women as well, who betrayed her husband and fell in love with someone else. He also fires at Yuzo's house but he escapes. Tsujio kills a lot of people in town, whom he considers evil. After this he goes out of town and commits suicide himself with his rifle. And thus this story ends. How did you like this? Do tell by commenting in the comment box. To see more such videos, subscribe the channel. Thanks for watching.